today. From Las Vegas, Nevada, it's the 2022 AFC NFC Pro Bowl. As we'll see Aaron Rodgers and the NFC versus Josh Allen and the AFC.
We are pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. For years, the NFL's best received a trip to Honolulu or Orlando for their efforts, but now they get a trip to Vegas as EA Sports welcomes you to Allegiant Stadium here in Southern Nevada. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and Charles, it's the Pro Bowl. You never really know what to expect, so I guess I'll ask you, what do you expect?
Well, in recent years, it has turned into an absolute offensive explosion, hasn't it? Games in the 50s are not out of line. What you're hoping is that some of these great defenders have a chance to adjust and react and maybe narrow that down a little bit, but I will say, this game is tilted heavily towards the offense's advantage.
So here comes the AFC for their opening drive. They're led out by their Pro Bowl quarterback in his fourth season from Wyoming, Josh Allen.
I know he's not showing it on the outside, but inside, he's got to be celebrating, because think about all the quarterbacking we saw in the AFC this year. Five or six guys could have earned this honor. He got the nod, a real feather in his cap.
So they fake the handoff. Now Allen. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. A high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete.
I like the fact that he took the shot deep downfield. Even if you don't get the catch, maybe you get a defensive penalty and pick up the yardage that way.
Even with that broken tackle, can't go very far. Stop short of the 30. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
And he'll get this underneath to Henry. A great effort there to shed the contact, and it helps him pick up the first.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. In this case, he picks up a first down.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Allen's throw taken in by Diggs. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people, but you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Again to Henry. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Second down, they go again with Henry. And he stopped after a gain of 1. Not enough. Still a yard to go on third down.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on third and 2.
Hello, baby, there it is.
Let's go.
If you make the stop there, maybe you hold them to three on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up three, possibly giving up six. Let's see what they decide to do here, because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working. And oftentimes we think about statement drives in the second halves of games, especially in the fourth quarter. But here, it's happening early, a definite statement.
And he is into the end zone for an AFC touchdown. Derrick Henry, a three-yard touchdown run. And the AFC takes it all the way down the field to score on their opening drive. So the AFC, they won the Pro Bowl the last couple of seasons and off to another good start here.
Yeah, how about that? The first touchdown of this game, how many more do we expect to see?
Hopefully a lot. I want offense in this ball game.
I don't think there's any question about it. Rarely do you get defensive struggles in the Pro Bowl.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. So out comes the NFC for their initial drive. They'll be led out by the reigning MVP of the National Football League, now in his 17th season out of Cal. It's Aaron Rodgers.
And no doubt about it, it was a banner year for quarterbacks in the NFC. A number of guys could very well have been selected for this. But I thought he stood out. I thought he found a way to separate himself from the pack. And he's been rewarded as the starting quarterback in the Pro Bowl. Definitely the right choice in my book.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here, up to the 34.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Those are the types of runs they told us they want to see more of. Look, they'd love the 60 to 70 yard runs, but those 10 to 20 yarders, they can help you win a ball game.
And that means everyone's invested, because you know the big guys up front, that's what they do. They try and move people. But when you get your perimeter guys involved downfield, that means that they care about the running game and they know it helps their team.
7 yards, the pickup there.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Now a play fake. Rodgers. Well, the pressure gets home and the AFC comes up with a sack. Harold Landry came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And he gets this one to Ridley complete. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Here's Corey Bohorquez to punt this thing away. And this one goes angling out of bounds, and it will be spotted inside the 30-yard line. So now the AFC offense here coming back out for their second drive. I have to be thrilled with that first drive that got them the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a 2-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents. Basically, you're not going to outwork two guys very often.
Double coverage. I thought he was going to go somewhere else with the football. I get it. That's a stud wide receiver. You want to try to get him the football.
Yeah, sometimes you rely on him a bit too much. You forget the other options that are out there. But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play Never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Second down and 4. Play action. Now it's Allen. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, a pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least, it'll be fourth down. Too long for a field goal, too short to punt. That in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. And Allen's got it! And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
A first down carry for Henry. Heck of a broken tackle and able to work this down near the 23. 42 yards rushing for him now to this point.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Henry again on second down. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, where they call play side.
And he will take this in for an AFC touchdown. Derrick Henry with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the AFC adds on to their lead. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack. And you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line. And he's able to take it into the end zone.
Tyler Bass now for the point after. And it's good to make it 14-0. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And Derrick Henry able to finish it off with a touchdown run. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. So now we'll get our second look in this game at the NFC offense. They're staring at a 2-touchdown deficit, 14-0 the score as they regroup with first and 10. Here's Rodgers to throw. Over the middle, into the hands of Michael Thomas. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Now Rodgers. This one caught by Ridley. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy. Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
7 yards there on the first down screen play.
Good call there on first down. And Brandon, I'm getting better over the years at not screaming out screen, screen, screen with my defensive training. They want to keep those pass rushers honest, and they did so there, and they wind up picking up positive yardage.
Rodgers throw complete there to Thomas. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. They can't tackle him. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line.
For as much as we extol his route running and him as a pass catcher, he might be better with the ball in his hands. He did not want to go down there until he found the end zone. And while he didn't quite get there, he and his guys are set up near the goal line now. First and goal.
Now the NFC going to call the first of their 3 timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And he is in. Touchdown NFC. Ezekiel Elliott taking it in from 2 yards out. And the NFC able to draw a bit closer. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice changeup.
And now it's blocked. It's picked up. A live ball here, remember. But he will not be able to bring this one back, and the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
I know it's easy to kind of shrug off a blocked extra point, but this game is shaping up to be a tight one. The second half, this could prove crucial.
Yeah, we might look back on this one. We'll have to wait and see. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Derrick Henry trots back out there and gets ready to go. And he's found the end zone twice, and now the offense for the AFC set to go now. And they'll have 50 seconds to work with, so that really plenty of time to try to put something together. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Second and 10. Allen. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
He's going to look downfield for Henry. That went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the NFC will take over first and 10. One final possession for the NFC in this first half. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Airing this one out for Evans. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So we race the flag. They decline it.
And did they use the big eraser, or was that the one at the end of the number 2 pencil?
Well, I was thinking the 2x2-inch ones that you can buy in addition to the pencil.
And those last forever.
A long time.
No doubt.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. picked off by the linebacker, Miles Jack. Wow, a big mistake there. Late interception in this first half, and that could lead to a field goal try the other way.
Yeah, I think at this point you just had to say, let's take a knee and go into the half and regroup. Let's just talk it over a little bit. I wonder, partner, was the analytics coach in his head a little bit? Maybe go ahead and press it and try and get some points? While the old school coach probably would have said, take the knee, let's get out of here.
Now we could see points the other way here. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Partner, this is almost an unwinnable spot for a defense. They have to come right out for a first and goal trying to stop them. But let me hold on a second. Let me take that back real quick. They can win here if they force a field goal try. Still a long ways away from that happening, but that has to be what they're thinking right now.
The kick by Bass is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we have hit halftime of the Pro Bowl with the AFC leading the NFC. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports.
Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter. It's the NFC to possess it first as we are back and underway for the third quarter. And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback. Now Aaron Rodgers and the offense heading back onto the field. And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, well, get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little and kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to...
Pressure, and the AFC gets to him for the sack. A well-designed corner blitz that gets him for a loss of 8 yards.
I'd say it's not panic time yet, but let's be honest about it. Empty possession here, not what you're looking for when you're down a couple of scores.
Absolutely not. Trying to start the second half off on the right foot. Unfortunately, going to give the ball up.
And he's got a man, Calvin Ridley. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, but he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense. Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And a nice job there, skipping away from the one tackle and ends up getting 5 yards out of that. 2nd down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Meanwhile, Rodgers throw into the hands of Pitts here. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down. Now Rodgers to Evans on the slant. And he's going to get this inside the 30. On play action, it's Rodgers. Oh, look at Thomas, wide open. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
And I'll tell you what, this offense is playing a little bit of keep away right now. They've come out here in the third quarter, possessed the ball for quite a while, and they keep on converting.
That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off, Byron Jones. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Now this one has been fun so far, as the Pro Bowl usually is. A lot of relaxed faces out there. Second and 10.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And all the way down to the 26. A big play there for the AFC.
Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there.
Now Allen again. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Before they can snap it, time runs out on this third quarter of play. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
Running left, it's Henry. And he will take this in for an AFC touchdown. Derrick Henry. A 13-yard touchdown run. And the AFC is able to widen their advantage. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And the lead is up to 18 now.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out, as their drive will begin at the 25. The NFC about ready to set up shop offensively. And it's great to see the stars all out in one place, but in terms of football, what's really great to see is a very entertaining Pro Bowl as we are tied in the fourth quarter.
And how many of these guys thought going into this game, after a pretty easy week heading into it, that the pressure would ratchet up now and someone has to make a play? Which means someone will have a play made against them and not have to live with that for the rest of the year.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. To throw, it's Rodgers. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. They go to Elliott again. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. A one-yard gain there following the three-yard pickup on first down. The numbers for the NFC on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Open man is Michael Thomas. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation. Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. 46 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
But they've certainly been successful throwing it around in this game, and that's allowed them to move the ball on offense. But I've got to tell you, to watch them run the football and successfully, I'm not taking sides. But to see the ball in the running back's hands, oh, that's football for me.
That catch good for only a couple. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's the NFC with the football as we welcome you back. They've got it second and goal as they look for a late touchdown. Second down and goal. Rodgers. And that's going to be caught. Touchdown NFC. Michael Thomas there to make the grab. And the NFC able to get a bit closer. This time, the extra point up and good. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. 2 scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this is going to be secured by the AFC. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. They run with Henry on first down, but nothing much materializing as he'll get forward only for about a yard. So 2nd and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. So Allen's going to look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Henry. Now the NFC going to take a timeout, their second. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And down inside the 15 he goes.
Now the NFC going to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And he will take this in for an AFC touchdown. Derrick Henry taking it in from 14 yards out. And the AFC adds on to their lead.
Great play, but admittedly, the tackling in the Pro Bowl, Charles, not always the best.
I would say that they're not quite as committed to getting a guy on the ground in the Pro Bowl as maybe during the regular season and, of course, in the playoffs. But still, heck of an individual effort there on that run.
Bass on for the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. So that drive, four plays. And Derrick Henry able to finish it off with a touchdown run. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Here now the NFC to take over on offense.
Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Throwing now is Rodgers. That is hauled in by Michael Thomas. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Rodgers now on first down. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agree. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
This is caught by Evans. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Kaiser White. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Partner's bad enough when you just can't hold on to the football. But when your quarterback's throwing it to the other team, that's 3 interceptions now, 4 turnovers for the game. You really have no chance to win the football game.
And he's going to be unable to get upfield as they take him down at the 21-yard line. So, Charles, final thoughts on this AFC victory.
Bottom line, nobody appeared to be seriously hurt. That's the first thing we look for in this game. Well played, a lot of fun, a lot of excitement. I think that everyone's going to go home pretty happy, especially the AFC since they won the game.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. So long, everybody.